In 1939, he was signed by the young Harry James for $75 a week. They became fast friends, and it was with Harry that Frank began to develop his style. They went on the road playing one-nighter after one-nighter. These were hungry years, but they were some of Frank's happiest.
Well, it was a typical old-fashioned Greyhound bus. The cigarette smokers and the guys who smoked the little grass always sat in the back of the bus where their windows were open, but they didn't realize that the slipstream was blowing it back into the bus again, which was absolutely hysterical. You could see the guys and a few of the guys down in front who were partially square, but maybe would like to have been back there. You could see them take a deep breath once in a while when the smoke would come blowing back in again.
It was with Harry James that he made his first hit recording of All or Nothing at All. Soon afterward, he got an offer to join the more popular Tommy Dorsey band. It meant more exposure and a lot more money. Even though Harry James had an ironclad two-year contract with his friend, he tore it up and allowed Frank to join Tommy Dorsey. Frank never forgot Harry's generosity, and they remained friends for life. On the road with Dorsey was also memorable for Frank.
First of all, Tommy, he'd get in the bus and sit down like this, and before he had it out of second gear and the zombie, Tommy was like this, gone. He was fast asleep. He had a knack, and none of us could sleep because, you know, particularly on winter nights, it was brutal with the windows ice cold and trying to sleep against the window. Now, I was never aware of these kind of problems because I was so happy. I really was so happy to be working, being on the road. And the big thrill was we go into the ballroom, wherever we were working, and get on the stand, everybody get ready to go, and the curtain would open up. That was the biggest thrill in the world, the sound of those kids when that thing opened up.
In 1941, Billboard named Sinatra top band vocalist. He was becoming a major draw.
1940 and break number two. I was now a singing employee of Tommy Dorsey, the General Motors of the band business. And man, the loot was out of this world. Every single week, 125 clams. But even more fabulous, I was rubbing elbows with TD's arranger geniuses such as Axel Stordahl, Cy Oliver, Paul Weston, Dean Kincaid, etc., etc., etc. What did I learn from T-Bone Dorsey? Well, just about everything I know about phrasing and breath control. In fact, I may be the only singer who ever took vocal lessons from a trombone. Old T.D. could blow that thing a whole week on one tank of air, and I latched on to his secret. Above all, though, Tommy taught me discipline, self-discipline, total dedication to every detail of every musical effort. That doesn't mean you call me perfectionist. It's just that I respect every record I make as if, well, it's the last song I'll ever sing.
Joe Stafford was singing with the Pied Pipers in Tommy Dorsey's orchestra. She remembers the first day she set eyes on Francis Albert Sinatra.
Frank joined the band about 2 weeks after the Pipers. And we were on the stand together the entire time Frank was with the band.
I'll never smile again until I smile.
When you're with a band, it gets very clicky. And when a new person comes in, it's like kind of standoff. You prove yourself, kiddo, you know, before you become one of the group. And we were going to we had left Chicago, the Palmer House, and we were going to open a theater in Milwaukee. And we knew that this new boy singer was going to join the band, but we didn't have to have anything to do with the early rehearsal because we knew what we were going to do. They were just going to have to rehearse some things with him. So we never saw him until we were just sitting on the bandstand when Tommy announced this new singer was starting that morning with the band. And out on the stage walked this very skinny, unprepossessing looking young man, and I thought, wow, you know, is this the hero image of our boy singer? He sang about 8 bars, and that whole theater became so quiet you could have heard a pin drop, and you just knew that you were hearing something quite unique, just quite unique. And it was very thrilling and thrilled all of us blasé folks sitting up there. I guess it just started building. I mean, it was not an overnight thing. It just started building. And I suppose after he'd been with a band for 8 or 9, 10 months, then when you'd play places where the places it was obvious would be places like the Paramount Theater. And that used to be wild. That used to be a thing, you know, where the band, the pit came up, and then at the end of the show would go down. And in those days, I remember almost getting scalped. We used to wear, in those days, with the flowers in the hair and things, you know. And when the pit would go down, the first row or first couple, they could really get to you, you know. And they used to just almost scalp me, ripping those flowers out of my hair because I sat next to Frank Sinatra.
West of the sun,
babe, in the brightness.
West of the moon,
we'll be digging a glow.
We'll build a dream house,
a righteous path
of love,
where you can really lay it on me.
Near to the sun in the day,
we'll be jumping.
Near to the moon at night,
you'll be with me.
We'll live in a lovely way,
solitude, I'm here.
Living on love and pale moon,
you're mellow.
Just you and I,
we'll nix the squares
forever and a day.
So long, so long.
Love will not die,
we're together forever.
We'll keep it that way
forever.
Up among the stars we'll find a harmony of life to a lovely tune. East of the sun and west of the moon,
on a June night, dear, kiss me and hold tight forever.
East of the sun and west of the moon.
Well, all right then, take 'em, bunny.
Thank you.
such things a dream for two. Someone to whisper, darling, you're my guiding star. Not caring what you own, but just what you are—a peaceful sky. this love of mine goes on and on. Though life is empty since you have gone, you're always on my mind, though out of sight. It's lonesome through the day and overnight. It's bound to break, since nothing matters, let it break. I ask the sun and the moon, the stars that shine, what's to become of it, this love of love belongs to somebody else.
Like the bear, you ain't nowhere, that's why.
She sings her songs for somebody else.
Whoa, whoa, whoa. And even when you have your arms around her, Papa, you know,
her thoughts are for somebody else. And when I hold her hand,
you know,
they belong to someone,
somebody else.
And you can bet they're not so cold to somebody else. It's tough to be alone on the shelf, and it's worse to fall in love by yourself.
Like when the one you love,
the one you love,
oh, the one you love,
the one you love.
Like when the one you love belongs to somebody else. Stop saying you're mine. Do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-
I guess I'll have to dream the rest. If you can't remember the things that you said, the night that my shoulder held your sleepy head, if you believe that parting's best, I guess I'll have to dream the rest. I guess I'll have to dream alone of honeymoon cruises once dear to my heart, of one-room apartments where we said we'd start, of foolish things we'd planned to own. I guess I'll have to dream alone.
I can see that your heart has gone astray. As for me, I love you the same old way.
I guess I'll have to dream the rest. There'll be no friends waiting to throw shoes and rice. Those heavenly moments will never come twice. I'm thankful for the hours you've blessed. I guess I'll have to dream the rest. Friends waiting to throw shoes and rice. Those heavenly moments will never come twice. I'm thankful for the hours.